I designed and built a nice gauge. However, I found that sometimes the noise of the stepper motor is a bit too loud. Today it's about how to make the stepper motor quiet. Actually, I really like the analog display instrument, especially because it's big and stylish. If you want, you can build it yourself. The components are really cheap and I'm providing all building instructions as well as the files for the 3D printing on this channel. When I measure dynamic signals with the display instrument, then there is a problem that bothers me. In my case here, the device shows the current audio volume. Unfortunately, you can hear a strange noise even from a distance of 1 meter. I'm going to get close so that you can hear it even better. When the pointer moves, there is a crackling noise caused by the stepper motor.
The right filter coefficients. Therefore, I have provided a small Excel tool.
Not really loud, but simply bothering. By the way, if you operate the device behind a glass pane in a cupboard, you won't hear the noise. Anyway, I really want to do something about the root cause of the crackling noise. Is that really possible? I thought about it a bit and I found 3 different possibilities. The first possible solution would be to prevent the transmission of mechanical vibrations to the housing. I screwed the stepper motor to the housing with 2 M2 screws. The solution is mechanically very stable. However, the vibrations of the stepper motor are transmitted very well to the housing. For this reason, the crackling noise is unfortunately kind of amplified. If you instead soldered the stepper motor to the circuit board and mounted the circuit board in a rubber mount, then the noise would be transmitted less to the case and would be less audible. Okay, I might consider that later for an improved design. The second solution is to use a proper stepper motor driver. I had chosen the simplest solution, in which the stepper motor is only operated with a square wave signal from 4 digital Arduino outputs. We can imagine that the voltage steps of the square wave signals are causing small mechanical shock waves that we perceive acoustically as crackling. A stepper motor driver generates a signal that approximates a sine wave using several small steps. As a result, the voltage steps are becoming much smaller and the movement of the stepper motor is more harmonious. Incidentally, this also increases the number of steps for 1 revolution by a factor, which can be 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128 or even up to 256. There are even stepper drivers that claim to be particularly quiet. Unfortunately, I couldn't find a stepper motor driver that can work with 5 volts. Most of them only work from 9 volts on. So, if you have a higher voltage available, then that's a nice solution that offers even higher angular resolution. But I would like to stick with this simple solution, as the gauge can be powered from any USB port on a PC, a power bank or a simple USB charger. So, I had to find another solution. The crackling noise is mainly caused by the steep voltage slopes of our square wave signals that are hammering on the stepper motor coils. And this is generating high frequency signal components. I have to somehow get rid of these in order to reduce the crackling noise. And what can be done against high frequencies? Yes, you can use a low pass filter and we are instantly going to dimension it using an RC element. But how can we dimension it? First, we ask ourselves what the maximum series resistance R can be. For this, we consider the following. The current flowing through the stepper motor coils should not be significantly reduced. The resistance of the coils is 260 ohms. at 5 volts. The current is 5 volts divided by 260 ohms equals 19 milliampere. If we put a 68 ohms resistor in series on each Arduino output, then the current is 5 volts divided by 396 ohms equals 12 milliamperes. Okay, with a current reduction of about 37%, the stepper motor can still work. However, the maximum angular velocity may be somewhat lower with the lower current. Next, we need to calculate the size of the capacitor. We remember that we set a delay of 8 milliseconds in our C++ code to define the length of our control signals. Our RC element should now transmit signals with a length of 8 milliseconds well and significantly dampen high-frequency signal components. This tells us what the time constant of the RC element must be, namely a little less than 8 milliseconds. The time constant of an RC element is simply calculated from R times C. If we use a 100 microfarad capacitor, we get a time constant of 6.8 milliseconds. So we add 4 RC elements to our Arduino control unit. With the small modification, our circuit looks like this. Since the coil current flows between the Arduino outputs, we practically have 2 RC elements in series. Now, of course, I'm very curious to see whether this measure is really effective. Therefore, we are now repeating the experiment with the same video from a well-known YouTube channel. And ta-da!
Even when the principle is simple, it is unfortunately not so easy to determine the right filter coefficients.
We can hardly hear the sound of the stepper motor. If we get very close, we can just perceive that the stepper motor is working, but the difference is really significant. The crackling is almost completely gone. In comparison, again the original circuit without the RC elements. And now again with the RC elements. My solution with the RC elements actually works quite effectively. I haven't changed the mechanical construction until now, because you can hardly hear the stepper motor anymore. The RC elements have really brought significant progress, and we also learned how to dimension them. By the way, the angular velocity isn't reduced significantly. Now I'm looking forward to present further interesting applications for the display instrument. Now stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.